factors that affecting adsorption of gases on solids. In that I have discussed already about the surface area of adsorbent and the nature of gas. Later I have discussed effect of temperature also. Let's see the fourth factor. Effect of pressure. Effect of pressure on the adsorption of a gas on solid surface. I have already explained that in the case of physical adsorption, what happens? Multi-layer formation takes place with increase in pressure. When you increase pressure of the gas, multi-layer formation takes place. Whereas in chemical adsorption, only a single layer is formed. So, in physical adsorption, what is the other name for physical adsorption? Physisorption. In physisorption, multi-layers of adsorbent are formed. Multi-layers of adsorbate gas. Are formed. Whereas in the case of chemisorption, only single layer of adsorbate is formed. Moreover, with increase in pressure, here in case of physical adsorption, what happens? Extent of adsorption increases and finally it reaches a constant value. Whereas in chemical adsorption, effect of a pressure is complex. In chemical adsorption, effect of pressure is complex. To explain the effect of a pressure in adsorption process, there are two adsorption isotherms. What are adsorption isotherms? Adsorption isotherms. So these are the theories that explain effect of adsorption at constant temperature. There are two adsorption isotherm theories. What are those? In first one, Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Freundlich adsorption isotherm. This is the first theory which explains the effect of pressure on physical adsorption. See here, there is a mathematical relation for a Freundlich adsorption isotherm. What is that? X by M equals to K into P power 1 by N. X by M equal to K into P power 1 by N, where N value is greater than 1. This is Freundlich adsorption isotherm. In this, what are the terms involved? X by M is, already I had explained, X is mass of adsorbate in grams, where M is mass of adsorbent in grams, K a constant, here N and K are constants. This P is adsorption equilibrium pressure. Adsorption equilibrium pressure. So now let us write the logarithmic form of this Freundlich adsorption isotherm. Take logs on both sides. Log of X by M equals to log, it resembles log AB form. Log AB equals to log A plus log B. So in that way, log K plus log of P power 1 by N. That means log of X by M equals to log p power 1 by n means 1 by n log p plus log p. Okay, so we got a relation log x by m equals to 1 by n into log p plus log p plus log k. Okay, it resembles y equals to mx plus c. It resembles the equation y is equal to mx plus c, which gives a straight line not passing through RZ. So for that, when we draw a graph between log x by m versus log x by m on y-axis and log p along x-axis, it will give a straight line not passing through RZ. So this is the nature of graph. In this graph, the intercept, this is the intercept, which is equal to log k, where c is intercept, equal to log k. What is slope? Slope of this graph is equal to 1 by n. So in that way we can find out the slope. So this is the graph when it is drawn between log x by m versus log p. If you draw the graph directly between x by m and pressure, what happens is it will give a graph like this. So this is the graph drawn at temperature, constant temperature T1, at constant temperature T2, at constant temperature T3. So here what happened? X by M, P, they are directly, of course. But with increase in pressure, extent of adsorption increases up to some pressure. After that pressure, what happens? It remains constant. Extent of adsorption remains constant. Remains constant means parallel to x-axis. So at T1, T2, T3, we may see the same situation. So what we can conclude, up to some pressure only, in physical adsorption, up to some pressure only, extent of adsorption increases. After that pressure, it remains constant. Okay, so these curves are called what? Adsorption isotherms. Why? Because these are drawn at constant temperature. Now my question is, what is the relation among T1, T2, T3? Relation, which is more value, which is lesser value. How to say? Already effect of temperature on adsorption we have discussed. In that I said that physical adsorption with increase in temperature decreases. So this is the curve with more area. That means more extent of adsorption. So more extent of adsorption is at low temperature. This is the curve with lower area, lesser area. That's why it is higher temperature. So finally, what is the order of these three temperatures? T3 is the least temperature, T3 less than, T2 less than, T1. Why T1 is the highest temperature among the three? Because at the highest temperature, adsorption will be the least. Because in the effect of temperature, I explained it already. Physical adsorption, extent of physical adsorption decreases with increase in temperature. So here adsorption is lesser, here more. More adsorption means lesser temperature. That's why T3 is the least among the three. Okay, so this is Fraenkel's adsorption isotherm. Next, in this expression, see, the 1 by n value lies between 0 to 1. 1 by n value lies between 0 to 1. But the probable range is, probable range is 0.1 to 0.5. This is the probable range. Similarly, if you take 1 by n value 0, where 1 by n value 0, see, where here at a low pressure directly proportional, x by m is directly proportional to p at low pressures. But at high pressures, this x by m does not depend on pressure. That's why there is a line parallel to x-axis. Line parallel to x-axis means this term does not depend on p. That means at a high pressures, at a high pressure values, you know, 1 by n value equals to 0. 1 by n value equals to 0. That means in the Freundlich adsorption isotherm, what happens? P equals to, we have x is equal to k into p power 1 by n. If you substitute the n by n value 0, this is x is equal to k into p power 0. Anything power 0 means 1, that means x is equal to k. So x is x, not x, it is x by m. X by m equals to k. If x by m is equal to k, that means constant. That indicates what? Extent of adsorption does not depend on pressure. So, you know, it is an expression as per chemical kinetics, it is the expression for zero order reaction. It is the expression for zero order process. So, therefore, at high pressure, the process follows, this adsorption process follows zero order kinetics. Why zero order kinetics? Zero order means rate is equal to rate constant only. It also appears extent of adsorption means rate of adsorption. Rate of adsorption is equal to constant here. That's why rate of adsorption is equal to constant. That means follows zero order kinetics. Similarly, at low pressures, if pressure is low, then you know 1 by n equals to 1. Then substitute this value in the standard equation. And what happens? X by m equals to k into p power 1 by n. 1 by n means 1. So p power 1. You know this relation, it is the rate expression for first order kinetics. So adsorption at high pressure, at low pressure follows. Therefore, adsorption follows first order kinetics. Adsorption follows first order kinetics at low pressures. Okay? This is adsorption at high pressure. This is adsorption at low pressure. Adsorption at high pressure follows which order? Zero order kinetics. Important this is. Adsorption at high pressure follows zero order. In objective questions it will be asked. At high pressure and low pressure, the order of adsorption process are, in that way question will be asked. So at a high pressure, what is the adsorption, order of adsorption process? Zero. At a low pressure, what is the order of adsorption process? First order. Got it? So finally, there is a limitation in this theory. In this adsorption theory, adsorption isotherm theory, there is a limitation. This theory fails at high pressures. So what is the limitation of this theory? It fails at higher pressures because there is a constancy value. And at high pressure, there occurs a multi-layer formation. But this theory confined to single layer. But at high pressures, you know, in physical adsorption, multi-layers are also formed. That's why this theory completely fails at higher pressure. There, another adsorption isotherm theory was introduced. That is, Longmire adsorption isotherm. longmire adsorption isotherm. Second, it is second adsorption isotherm. What is that? Longmire adsorption isotherm. It is the first quantitative adsorption isotherm. As per a Longmire adsorption isotherm, we have extent of adsorption x by m is equal to AP by 1 plus BP. This is the relation. Here also P is adsorption equilibrium pressure, where AB are constants. AB are constants. Okay, P is adsorption equilibrium, adsorption equilibrium pressure. This is Longmire adsorption isotherm. As per this theory, see here also we can rearrange this equation like P by X by M. Okay, P by X by M, take X by M that side. Then A by 1 plus BP this side. So then what happens? 1 plus BP by A. Okay. Now P by X by M equals to B by A into P plus 1 by A. P by X by M is equal to B by A into P. It also resembles y is equal to mx plus c. So if you draw a graph between this term and pressure, you will get a straight line not passing through origin. So here a graph is drawn between which terms? P by x by m. Because p is variable, x, m all variable terms, that's why. Along the x-axis, which term? P. What is the nature of graph? Y is equal to mx plus c. You know, at adsorption isotherm, so T is constant. Okay, remember this point. T is constant, then only it is said to be isotherm. So here, P by X by M versus P gives a straight line not passing through origin. In this, the intercept, in place of intercept, which one is there? 1 by A. Similarly, slope equals to in M here slope, in place of M there is B by A. So slope is B by A, intercept is 1 by A. Let's see the cases of this Longmire adsorption isotherm. Cases. There are three cases: at a low pressure, at high pressure, and at moderate pressure. Okay? So let's see the first case. First case, at a low pressure. See, at low pressure what happens? If P is low, 1 by BP, 1 plus BP can be considered as 1. Why 1? Because P is smaller. So B into P is smaller value. In comparison with 1, we can ignore BP. Then 1 plus PP can be considered as 1. Then the above equation becomes X by M equals to AP. X by M equals to AP. This implies X by M is directly proportional to P. So at low pressure, extent of adsorption increases with increase in pressure, because these two are directly proportional, that's why. Extent of adsorption increases with increase in pressure. So this is the case at low pressures. Okay. See the second case, at high pressures. At high pressures, what happens? This BP, 1 plus BP can be taken as BP. Why? Here P is more. That's why BP value is far greater than 1. BP value is far greater than 1. That's why we can ignore one in comparison with the one BP. So now the above equation becomes XYM equals to AP by BP. So here P constant gets cancelled. P is same in both numerator and denominator, no? That's why it gets cancelled. Then X by M is equal to, we got A by B. That means X by M is equal to constant by constant gives another constant. So extent of adsorption is constant. That means follows zero order. Here zero order. But here it follows first order. So at a low pressure, extent of adsorption follows first order. At a high pressure, extent of adsorption follows zero order. That is the concept explained by Fraenkel's adsorption isotherm also. See the third case at moderate pressures. At a moderate pressure, you know, at moderate pressure, extent of adsorption X by M equals to K into P power 1 by N. It follows this equation where 1 by N value lies between 0 to 1. So in that way, Longmire also has explained the extent of physical adsorption. Okay, in chemical adsorption, the effect of pressure is very complex. So that's why in physical adsorption only we discuss these two adsorption theories.